Hello. Today, let us look at some numericals on Kumar preparatory. This is the passage of material. This is the machine, the way it looks. This is the passage of material through sliver lap machine. And this is the gearing diagram. So the gearing diagram in detail is given over here, whereas you can calculate the RPM of each and every part in the sliver lap machine through the gearing diagram. So, and these are the values. Calculating surface speed, we know that we can calculate surface speed as pi d n. If we know the diameters of all the parts, we can, and we know the RPM, we can calculate the surface speed in inches per minute like this. Once we calculate the surface speed in inches per minute, we can always calculate the draft between each part by dividing surface speed of delivery roller upon feed roller, and these are the values that we get. We can calculate the total draft also, and we can also verify the total draft by multiplying each of the intermediate drafts, and we can compare them, we get the same values. We can also calculate the draft constant as draft into CP, and we get this value for sliver lap machine with the gearing diagram that we have seen earlier. We now come to the first sum. In a sliver lap machine, if 20 slivers of 60 grains per yard are fed and 560 grains per yard lap is produced, calculate the draft on the machine. So this is the first part of our problem, where we calculate the draft as grains per yard fed upon delivered into number of doublings, and we get the answer by substituting as 2.414. Now we should take care over here that since it's a sliver lap machine, the feed is the sliver and the delivery is the lap. So we take the appropriate values and substitute them in the formula. So the next part of our problem is, for delivering the same lap, if the draft is increased by 10, what hank of sliver should be produced? So we calculate the 10% higher draft, that is 2.14 into 110 upon 100, we get 2.35. So what we've been told is that the draft is increased by 10, and so what is the hank of the sliver that should be fed to deliver a lap of hank of 560 grains per yard? So again, using the same formula above and substituting the new value of draft here, we get 2.35 is equal to x upon 560, which we have to keep constant, and also the number of doublings. So we get the value of sliver fed in grains per yard as 65.9. But we have been asked to calculate the hank of the sliver that should be fed. So we calculate the hank from this by using the formula. Hank is equal to 8.33 divided by 65.9, that's 0.126. So we come to the second sum. Here we have to calculate the production per shift of 8 hours in a sliver lap machine in which the calendar ruler of 5 inches diameter is making 110 RPM. The draft in the machine is 2, hank of each sliver fed is 0.129, efficiency is 85%, and a number of slivers fed is 20. So for calculating any kind of production, we need two values. One is the surface speed of the output ruler and the hank of the material that is delivered. So here, as we can see, we have been given the data for the output ruler, that is 5 inches and 110 RPM, but we have not been given the output ruler hank, output material hank, so we need to calculate it. But we have been given draft and the number of doublings over here, as well as the feed sliver hank. So we first calculate the hank of the lap delivered by using the formula, and we get the value as 0.0129. Then we can calculate the production easily in pounds per shift as by multiplying pi into d into n. Since it is shift, we multiply by 60 into 8, then we divide by 36 to convert inches per shift into yards per shift. Then we divide by 0.0129 into 840. This we do to convert this yards per shift into pounds per shift. And we multiply by efficiency that is given to us, that is 85 by 100. And we get the production in pounds per shift as 1806.26. So let us come to the third problem. what would be the weight per yard of lap and the number of laps delivered per shift of 8 hours from a saliva lap machine in which the lap roller are 14 inches in diameter running at 20 rpm. Each of the 20 slivers fed weigh 62 grains per yard and the draft in the machine is 2.08. The length of each lap is found to be 300 yards. So let us first understand what has been asked here. We have been asked what would be the weight per yard of lap and the number of laps delivered per shift of 8 hours. So let us go stepwise. First we calculate using this formula for draft. We use the appropriate values at the places. We see that grains per yard fed is 62, so we substitute here 62. We have to find out the grains per yard delivered of the lap. So we keep it as x, number of doublings have been given as 20 and draft as 2.08. So we calculate lap weight in grains per yard as 596.15. And then to calculate the number of laps delivered in a shift of 8 hours, we'll first need the length delivered by the machine in yards in a shift of 8 hours. So once we know the length delivered and divide that by the length in each lap that is given to us, we'll find the number of laps delivered. So therefore the production we find out in yards per shift because we have been asked per shift how many laps have been delivered. So yards per shift we calculate, which is pi into D into N, which will give us inches per minute. Multiply that by 16 to 8, we get inches per shift, divide that by 36 and we get yards per shift. So we get this yards per shift as this answer, which we divide by 300, which is given to us. Each lap length is 300 yards. So we get around 39 laps delivered in a particular shift. So coming to the next problem, we have 24 card slivers, each of 50 grains per yard are fed to the sliver lap machine, the draft of 1.5. The lap roller is 12 inches in diameter and runs at 40 rpm. Calculate the production in kgs per shift of 8 hours at 80% efficiency. So this is quite a straightforward problem, except that we have been given again the data of feed material, whereas we need to find the data for delivered material hank or grains per yard. So we do that first. So by using again the same formula, we get lap weight in grains per yard as 800 grains per yard. And then we can easily calculate the production first in pounds per shift as pi into D into N into 60 into 8, which gives us inches per shift divided by 36, we get yards per shift. When we multiply that by 800, which is grains per yard over here, we can convert the answer into grains per shift. Divide that by 7000, that is a conversion unit. We get pounds per shift here. And when we multiply by efficiency, we get pounds per shift at 80% efficiency. This particular answer, 1837.35 is in pounds. We have been asked in kgs. So divide this by 2.205 and we get 833.26 kgs per shift. So having seen all the problems on saliva lap machine, we go to the ribbon lap machine. Here is the machine image. This is the passage and this is the gearing diagram. So in the passage, one thing to note is that the feed also is a lap and the delivery is also a lap. So in the problem, we must be very careful as to what we are actually calculating. So we'll see in a short while. Just like before, saliva lap machine, this is the gearing diagram and these are the calculations. Maybe you can just verify them and see these are the answers we get. We can, as before, we can calculate the draft for the entire machine, that is total draft, by calculating the feed and the delivery surface speed of lap rollers, and we get the total draft is 8.28. We can also calculate the intermediate drafts and calculate the draft constant. These are some values that are given, which you can verify. Coming to a sum on ribbon lap machine. If in a 6-head ribbon lap machine, each of the lap fed weighs 520 grains per yard and the draft in the machine is 6.05, calculate the weight of the lap in pounds produced in 10 hours of uninterrupted working. When we say uninterrupted working, we know that the efficiency is 100%. Also calculate the weight of the lap delivered in grains per yard if the 14 inch diameter delivery lap roller runs at 22 rpm. So we have been given here this delivery lap roller data, so we don't have to worry about this. But we have been again given the feed data over here, so we need to calculate the delivery material grains per yard here first. So by using again the same formula, we get delivery lap weight in grains per yard as 515.7 grains per yard. So now difference here is we have been asked for the production for 10 hours. So production in pounds per 10 hours, we appropriately then change on the right hand side. Pi into D into N will give us inches per minute. Multiply by 60 will give us inches per hour. Multiply that by 10, we'll get inches per 10 hours. Divide that by 36 and we get yards per 10 hours delivered. And when we multiply this thing by 515.7, which is grains per yard delivered, we would get the answer in grains per 10 hours. Divide that by 7000, which is the conversion for grains and pounds. So we get the answer in pounds per 10 hours. So 1187.49 pounds are delivered in 10 hours for this particular ribbon lap machine. So with this, we come to the end of this numerical session. Thank you.